All right, welcome back inside our proactive newsroom. And joining me now is Simon Marcotte. He is the CEO of Royal Fox Gold. And Simon, it's good to have you along. How are you?
Thank you very much for having me on, Steve. I'm very, very good. How are you?
I'm doing well, thank you. And also joining us is Michael Gentile, who is a director with Northern Superior. And Michael, it's great to see you as well.
Same here, Steve. Good to see you.
So pretty exciting news out from both of these companies. A merger is in the wind. And I'm going to begin with Simon to talk a little bit about the reasoning behind deciding to get Royal Fox to join Northern Superior. Simon?
Yeah, I mean, we have quite an opportunity here to put something together as we are now consolidating the camp of Chibougamau. And in the gold space, a lot of very successful companies were put together by consolidating a camp, but rarely do you have the opportunity to do it. And this is an opportunity that's taking hold now in the province of Quebec and the reason behind the merger.
Yeah. Simon, just for shareholders themselves, why do you think it's in the best interest of them for this particular merger?
Oh, it's scale. All right. So Northern Superior already has very attractive properties, properties with a great potential, very nearby properties. And putting it with our Philibert project really creates geological scale and can be looked at from an economic perspective as one and only operation that will eventually feed the same mill. And that's really how you start to come. Interestingly enough, that's how Agnico Eagle was started, right? Agnico Eagle many years ago was the merger between Agnico and Eagle Mines. And they consolidated a camp, interestingly enough, in Matagami, 300 kilometers to the west only of where we're at.
Yeah. Michael, just your thoughts on what Royal Fox is offering in this particular merger, especially with their project as well. This sounded like it is something that sort of needed to happen. Is that fair to say?
Absolutely. Steve, if you look at 3-4 months ago, there was, you know, 5 resources or resource stage or pre-resource stage discoveries in the camp owned by 4 companies. If you fast forward to today, those 5 resources are now owned by 2 companies, and the companies would be IM Gold and now Northern Superior combining with Royal Fox. So that really camp level consolidation Simon's talking about is extremely important for shareholders. You talk about a mine plan, a development scenario. Getting 4 companies to agree on anything is almost impossible. And so if you have 2 companies that own majority of the resources in the camp, we think resources are very significant. And between these 2 companies, your ability to move a mine forward, get a development plan going. And ultimately what I care about as a larger shareholder is increasing the value of those ounces in the ground, making them cash flowing ounces at some point in the future. That's the logic and rationale behind this merger. I mean, in terms of Philibert, the deposit of Royal Fox, we see a lot of upside. Look at the deal structure, the maximum payment that the Royal Fox shareholders can receive is if their upcoming resource has more than 2 million ounces in the first initial resource calculation. So clearly at Northern Superior, we saw significant upside in the Philibert deposit, and coupled with our existing substantive property position in the camp, makes it even more valuable together.
Michael, how do you now attack a project? I know you're going to be one of the lead directors in this new sort of merger company together, as you are a director with Northern Superior. But how do you attack when you've got 2 companies coming together with multiple projects? How do you sort of attack that?
Yeah, so the great news of this merger, Steve, is we had a great team in Northern Superior. I think we're really strong on the technical geoscience side. We have a great advisory committee. Our former CEO, Tom Morris, who's retiring this year, will be replaced by Simon Marcotte. And so we're adding, you know, Simon Marcotte, who's got a great background in capital markets, mining entrepreneur, Victor Cantoria as our executive chairman, who is the backer and founder of Amex Exploration, a very successful company in Quebec. You'll have myself, and we're retaining all the key geoscience, geophysical, geological team members in Northern Superior. So we're really marrying the best of both worlds. And as a much larger company, as you know, people drive this business. I think we're adding a lot of talent to this team, so we'll be better able to prosecute and advance these opportunities systematically over the coming years.
Simon, was that a big part of this as well, to make sure that your project got sort of the love it deserved into this new entity, and to make sure that you were continuing to move that forward?
Absolutely. Absolutely. If it was not going to happen today, it would have happened later. And today was a good opportunity to do it because we have this big resource calculation that will be published over the next few months, as Michael mentioned. We had to come up with an interesting structure where the current shareholders of Royal Fox will be compensated based on the size of that resource. We have more than 2 million ounces, then the transaction will be 0.18 shares of Northern Superior for each share of Royal Fox. to every shareholder of Royal Fox just before the closing of the transaction.
Okay. And lastly, Michael, just to you, where does this put Northern Superior now with the addition of Royal Fox and what they have as far as the mining landscape of Canada is concerned? Can you talk a bit about where that puts the company?
Yeah, I think it puts us in a whole new league. If you add the potential resource upside from Philibert, you add our land position. We're the largest landholder in the Chapay, 62,000 hectares, so a dominant land position in the camp. We see line of sight, and they're not published, so these are theoretical potential resource, but we see line of sight in the combined company by the end of next year, potentially having more than 4 million ounces of resource on the board. So you talk about that level of ounces, that level of land holdings and scale in a camp with significant geological exploration upside on all four properties that we'll now own in the camp. So that puts you in pretty rarefied air when you talk about those kind of numbers, that kind of scale. And as Simon mentioned, consolidating camp is very hard to do. It's a very rare opportunity. We've done that today with this transaction, which is why we're both so excited about what we see in the future for our shareholders.
I can imagine. Well, Michael, great to see you. Thanks very much. Congratulations on this and appreciate your time.
Thank you, Steve.
That's Michael Gentile, who is the director with Northern Superior. And Simon, as always, thank you. Nice to see you as well.
Thank you, Steve. I'll see you soon, I hope.
All right. There's Simon Marcotte, the CEO of Royal Fox, announcing the merger between the two companies.